Hey guys, I'm Dalton Hines. We're here in Honduras. We just got back to the compound. This week we want to just kind of give you a little bit of a tour of what it's like to come on a mission trip in Honduras. So Justin will tell you a little bit about that.
Hey, thanks Dalton. I just flew in from Tampa, Florida area. We got a pretty good sized group here and we're going to be building some houses. We're going to be going over and feeding some folks and doing a little bit of painting. I think we're visiting a children's home. We just wanted to take you guys on a journey, get the experience along with us and see what that's like. So we're going to be just taking you guys through it and we can't wait to have y'all. Guys, we're at Reach One, Teach One, the R1T1. You'll see the initials out here. Today we're painting one of the new facilities that they just got. They rented it, they put a new roof on it with the team last time. So this time we're putting a coat of paint on it, trying to get this thing watertighted in. Inside here, it's about 3,000 square feet. It's gonna house people, some devotionals. They're trying to get a lumber yard and a couple other things, lumber storage and tool storage going here. It's gonna be a great facility once it's all put together and we're doing it.
There was one particular time we were on a house build, got really rainy, finished the job, we're coming down a mountain, another roof collapsed on our way down, and part of our team, we had the tools, we had the equipment. This guy and his family were waiting there with a big hole in the roof in the middle of a rainstorm, and we were able to come down there, put their house back together pretty efficiently, again in the middle of that rainstorm, got back on the bus. And so it's not just about helping a particular project while we're here, but any needs that we see along the way going or coming from a job site that we can stop and help more people share Jesus with them and the purpose of why. Breaking off every chain and the fear that held me, I refuse to agree with the lies they told me. I take up my position, speak to all my conditions. Hey guys, coming at you from Los Alpes, Honduras, where we got a build going on here. This is our first build of the trip. We're pumped about it. It rained really, really heavy last night, so we were worried that we were gonna be in the clay, water, mud, and all kinds of stuff, but it's dried out a little bit, so we got the whole team here. So behind me, we just got through squaring up the 4x4 posts on the outside. We're gonna start building the house and we just wanna take you on the journey with that. So come on and just watch us as we build these. That way you guys kind of have an understanding of the housing here and then we'll go into who the family's for and so all that kind of stuff.
It's been very welcoming and heartwarming. I love how happy the families are when they finally see their house.
And I can see like a lot through that they don't have the same opportunities as us like in the U.S.
I had heard we were going to build houses, and I was super excited about that because my dad owned a construction business, and I was like, okay, I can totally do this. I get down there and I'm like, this is different. This is something so interesting that these 16 by 16 houses that we're going to build for these people to live in, I got to experience firsthand how to build a house with my bare hands, with just a nail and a hammer, and work together with a group of people, that it was just, it was magical.
Your life changes. The way God moves your heart, your mind, your soul, you're not the same person. You come back. It's straight from the Bible. You give water, you food, shelter, the people. Some of them don't have exactly nothing, but they're happy and content. But they have Jesus in their lives.
I didn't realize like how bad it like may have been for them, like the poverty, because where my family's from, they're a little bit more wealthy, and over here it seems like a bit of a struggle.
We got here and I was like, oh my goodness, what I experienced and what I went through and visually saw, and just the kids and the dump and all these different experiences that I had was just absolutely life-changing. Hey guys, beautiful out here in this country over in Honduras. This is one of our house builds. I just wanted to explain to the people in the United States what these houses consist of. The corner posts are 4x4 construction. The center supports for the walls are 2x4, what we would call in the States a shed. They will fit in Honduras about 8 to 10 family members on these. Once we're done, we'll put a little pitch on the roof. We'll put some tin, cut a doorway in there with chainsaws. No circular saws, no power tools, everything's hand nailed. But it's a beautiful time, beautiful country out here. Love for you guys to come along one day.
I think the safety here has been something that's really important for me to come back. And so we've been through some experience that on the surface may have appeared unsafe, but the people here, the organization here provides a place for us to be that is so safe.
Sound okay? Sound okay?
Okay. Okay.
My name is Justin. I'm from the Tampa, Florida area.
Yo voy a iniciar. How do I transition to you? What do you mean to say about you?
Hey, I'm Dalton Himes.
Go ahead, dude. I can't have little kids mowing
the lawn. Cisco, help a little man out.
This is the way we do it in Honduras.
Just make me look thin, you know?
You're good, Tim. Just don't slam the door.
How much taller? You're way taller than me over there.
Alto? Listo. Listo.
Listo. So here we are. We're actually going to give you a little bit of a journey here in Torch Missions. And this is just how it's going to start this week. And so he's going to tell you a little bit about... I should cut that. That was terrible.
No, it was fine.
No, it was terrible.
It was fine.
Terrible.
Fine. Terrible.
Otra vez. Una vez más. Tres. Hey guys, so this is Dalton, this is Justin, this is Dalton.
We need a
backstage. Hey, I want a copy of this, okay? Copy of it.
All right, dígame, uno, dos, tres. All right, hey guys, this is
you guys through it, and we can't wait to have y'all.
See you soon.